Welcome back. I'm Pastor Aminata with Who Is He and What Is He to Me? We're looking at the 23rd Psalm, the Psalm of David. Let's get busy. I'm just going to read it real quick. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And thereby goes the reading of the word. Just looking at it, like I said, this is Psalms 23, a very familiar passage to many of us. But what is David really saying? Is it just on the surface, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want, da 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 da? And if we really believe it, why are we not incorporating it like him? Or is he saying something a little bit deeper? So this is what I want us to do. I want us to take the time to break it down. So we're going to look at the Lord is my shepherd. In the Hebrew, the word Lord means Jehovah, the existing one. And Lord gives the significance of one who is a ruler, one who is a master. So David is saying, the Lord, my ruler, the Lord, my master, is my, and there it is. He understands that this is a personal relationship. He is my. So here's what I want you to do. If you have your Bible with you, I want you to put your name over the word my. The Lord is Anna's shepherd. The Lord is Mike's shepherd. The Lord is Orme's shepherd. The Lord is Jason's shepherd. The Lord is Beverly's shepherd. The Lord is Ramona's shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. I want you to write your name over the word my. And even if you don't have your Bible, when you go home, I want you to look at it and make sure you put your name over the word my. Why? Because I want us to begin to see that we, just like David, can begin to develop our personal relationship with God. So the Lord, the ruler, my master, is also my shepherd. And again, in the Hebrew, the word shepherd is a guide or a leader, a protector, one who looks after the sheep. All right? Now, I'm just one sheep, but it is still the shepherd's responsibility to provide for me, to lead me to pasture, to take care of me, to watch out over me. So that's what David was saying. He said, he is my Lord, he is my God, he is my master, but he is also my shepherd, my leader, my provider. Think about that. We, on the next time, we're going to finish up this one sentence, the Lord is my shepherd, and get into, and I shall not want. I'm Pastor Aminata. Y'all hang in there. I believe God has a word for you.
Accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and that I need God in my life. So I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. Amen. So if you prayed that prayer, I want you to drop us a line and email us and let us know, because right now you are saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and find yourself a Bible-believing church and continue to grow in grace. God bless you.